Tracy, we look back at Kevin playing in that game. Do you think it was a mistake?
I do not. And the reason I don't think it was a mistake is I'm sure Kevin had information that he received from the team doctors. I'm sure Kevin had his own doctors look into his situation. He got all the information that he needed to go out and play last night. And when you get the information that you need in terms of what could possibly happen if you go out and play, will you feel some discomfort? Or, you know, it's a possibility that you might, you know, further injure yourself. I'm sure he received that information, and Kevin went through probably a rigorous workout routine, felt great. As you see, before the game, he was out there shooting around, he was dunking. Even in the pregame, before they run out, his little dance move and, you know, that little step back, putting that pressure on that Achilles, he felt comfortable. So if you see how he played in that first quarter, I think if he would have continued to just be a spot-up shooter and not so much play on the ball, I think Kevin Durant probably could have lasted. But the minute he tried to go back and be himself and create off the dribble, that's when tragedy just happened.
If that's the case, then why let him play? You know, I think the reason why Bob Myers had that breakdown, the reason why he had the press conference, was because they did know that they had made a mistake. And I don't know if it was a mistake to play him 12 to 14 minutes that was in the game.
Right.
I don't know if it was a mistake to play him 45 minutes a game in the Houston series, which led to the calf injury in the first place. I don't have answers to these. I don't know how much the fact that Klay Thompson and Kevon Looney came back from injuries in the series, that Andre Iguodala is playing with his own calf injury, which is risking his Achilles as well. I don't know if those things, how much those affected Kevin. Those are all gray areas that only exist somewhere up in here with him. But it's a terrible moment for the league. Terrible. And Tracy, going forward, I think it's going to affect the way people, fans, and media, and maybe even teams look at players dealing with injury.
That hurt. I look at this.
Take a look, by the way, at what Kendrick Perkins said. He blames the Warriors.
Okay.
He feels that they were pressuring him
to
play.
Listen, I was with Kendrick Perkins last night. He came in the suite, and he told us, I guess he had communicated with KD's brother, that he tore his Achilles. He was pissed last night coming up in that suite and gaining that information. But there's a positive in all this from last night. KD gave an emotional lift to this team, and you saw how they played. I mean, they were missing on some scoring, you know, in these games that he wasn't playing. He provided 11 points for this team that we just don't know where they're going to get 11 points from the next game.
They only won by one.
So those 11 points
10 wouldn't have been enough.
Needed.
He needed the 11.
Devastating loss, but, you know, that win, I think KD has something to do with that.
You know, obviously we're invested in these games, but I'm not a fan of either of these teams. I'm a fan of the NBA. I felt sick last night. And I really had difficulty getting over that, and I have only the most little tangential relationship towards that team and that player. I don't even know how they're going to go forward from here. And I saw some people were second guessing whether Bob Myers was putting on a little act.
That was genuine.
Yeah.
I felt sick. Imagine if you're Bob Myers. Imagine if you're teammates. It was a terrible moment. I don't know whether it's worth trying to find blame. I just think we have to look at it as a terrible moment.
Yeah.
Well, look, you and I were sitting in the room before the game when Doris Burke gave her report, and she was saying how Steve Kerr had told them in the broadcast room that they didn't think he could do serious damage, that the worst that could happen was, okay, maybe he goes out and tweaks it again. But they had gotten past the point where they thought it had been serious damage. And that's what Steve Kerr told me in the hallway after the game. And he kept kind of just saying that, right? That, we didn't think it could happen this way. Bob Myers was your agent. Mm-hmm. Can you just speak to the people out there and explain how genuine
as genuine as they come. Great person. I've been knowing him my whole career. Probably one of my favorite people is being a manager of mine around this league. I mean, he was genuine last night on his words.
You've seen that from him.
I've seen, yes.
It's just, if you've been around Bob, I don't think you would ever say that wasn't real.
No.